Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. Please don't mind the towel. I literally had just gotten out of the shower. But anyways, we're gonna go ahead and start with the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. And we're gonna move on to the eyeshadow palette Greed by Wet n Wild. And we're gonna use this color on the entire eyelid. And here we're gonna go ahead and use the Huda Beauty Warm Brown Obsession eyeshadow palette. And we're gonna use that from the crease up to the brow bone. And here we're using my cheap eyeshadow palette called Amuse. We're using the color purple on the crease and on the corners of the eye. Again, we're using the same palette called Amuse, not sure, but we're using two colors mixed together, and we're gonna use these two colors on the middle of the eyelid. And again, we're using the Huda Beauty Warm Brown Obsession eyeshadow palette for below the waterline. And you're gonna bring it up to the corner of the eyelid. Once you have that done, we're gonna use the purple color from the Amuse palette. And you're gonna use that below the brown tone. And for the brows, I'm using the Elmer's Washable Glue Stick just to bring them up a bit and make them look extra bushy. And here you can use any brow brush you have to comb the eyebrows up. And here I'm going to use the Wet n Wild brow and eyeliner pencil to fill in the empty spaces on my brows. And with the e.l.f. brow comb and brush, I am blending in the brows to give it that fullness. And now we're moving on to the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Contouring Palette. And we are sure going to contour the ish out of our faces. We're gonna use it on our forehead. We're gonna use it on our cheekbones, our nose, our jawline, and down to our neck. And you can do it as deep as you like. Again, we're using the purple eyeshadow from the Amoose palette for the middle of our forehead. And then we're going to move on to the Huda Beauty Warm Brown eyeshadow palette from the middle of our forehead up to our hairline. And after that, we are using the gold eyeshadow from the Amoose palette as well for the corner of the eyes. And here I'm using the Wet n Wild brow pencil, the same one I used for my eyebrows, making kind of like freckles on my nose and on my cheeks. You can bring it up to your forehead or down to your mouth. But here I'm just using it on my nose and on my cheeks, and I'm covering that to blend it in, kind of make them look real with some translucent powder. And now we're moving on to the fun stuff. We are using the gold flakes with some adhesive. We're going to be adding it on the corner of our forehead. And then once we have it done on our forehead, we're moving on to our cheekbone. You can use it on both sides of your forehead or both sides of your cheekbone. But here I'm just using it on opposite sides, which is one side of my forehead and then the other side of my cheekbone. And for the lips, we are using the gel lip liner by Wet n Wild called Bear to Comment. And we're going to use that to outline the entire lip. And we are also going to use it on the corners of our lips. And now we're going to move on to the Sephora Lip Stories called No Cell Service Lipstick on the entire lip. And then we're going to use the same gold eyeshadow I used for the corner of the eyes on the lips, and then we're gonna add the Too Faced Lip Injection lip gloss. And we're also using the gold flakes for the corner of our eyes. And for the highlighter, I'm using the BH Cosmetics Carly Bibles eyeshadow and highlighter palette. I'm using it for my cheekbones, my nose, my forehead, and my chin. I'm also using it for my chest and my collarbones. And for mascara, we're using Renegade by Wet n Wild. Here we're using the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil for the waterline. And now we're moving on with the hair. I decided to do big curls because I was on a crunch time. This was literally a last minute costume. So this was the only thing that was gonna work for me at the time. But you can do smaller curls. I think it would be better with the costume, but it's really up to you. And also make sure to tease away the entire top half of your hair to give it a lot of volume. Am I the only one that makes these ugly faces when I'm doing my makeup or hair? This is horrible. Now here I'm parting the hair from the side, and I am going to tease again and again. And I wanted to tell you a little bit about the butterflies I'm going to be using. I purchased the butterflies for my hair at the Dollar Tree. They come in a pair, and I spray painted them gold. I got the spray bottle at Michael's, and I had a 60% coupon, which the bottle came out around $3 and some change. And then the butterfly wings, I got them also at the Dollar Tree. I spray painted the top wing gold. There were two separate wings, and I glued them together to make them look kind of like they're moving and make them look bigger. So a total, I spent about $2 for the wings, $2 for the hair wing butterflies, and $3-$4 for the bottle. So it was a total about $8. So there you guys have it, the last minute butterfly fairy costume. I really hope you guys enjoy watching this video. Please feel free to comment below on any tutorial you'd like to see next. Make sure you like and subscribe down below. Thank you so much for watching. Peace and love, guys.